all got internet personas. Internet personas we hide behind.
Hey guys, it is me, Kraken King, and today we're talking about some major Fallout overhauls. So I guess without further ado, let's just hop right into the list, which I am very happy I got this list. So number one, Fallout 4 New Vegas, or F4NV. That is a mouthful, gosh. I do indeed love New Vegas, and the fact that somebody is remaking it in Fallout 4, oh, that's amazing. It's been in development for about 3 years now, and honestly, it's looking great. The Fallout 4 development team is even releasing some parts of the mod, such as the N99 10mm pistol, which, of course, if you don't already know, it's the pistol from New Vegas. And they also released the anti-air rifle, and some lovely NCR armor. They're all linked in the description down below with just about everything else in this mod list. But it's gonna be cool seeing, New Vegas in a fully HD remake. They redid the perk chart as well. That's something that I thought was very cool. I like the perk chart in that one, and that's also up for download now, I think. But like I said, it's probably gonna take a few years to come out because they got to do all the armors, ammo, weapons, the entire map. Plus, 10,000 hours worth of voice acting. Yeah. They have to redo it because, well, you can't just copy and paste it into the... It's not allowed. They're not allowing them, basically. But I cannot wait for this mod to come out. I loved New Vegas' story, and I cannot wait to play it in full HD again. It'd just be fun to go back through it. Number two, this one's a bit shorter, but the Capital Wasteland. If you don't already know what the Capital Wasteland is, it's a Fallout 3 remake in Fallout 4. And basically, it's a classic Fallout 3 look. They also made the Point Lookout DLC. And that one's going to actually come out before the full mod comes out. Because it's easier to remake, obviously. Oh, sorry, guys. Got something in my throat. They have a few quests complete for both of them. In fact, Point Lookout's almost fully finished. Like I said, they remade Galaxy Radio, and they even made the full intro in HD, which I'll throw up on screen real quick. I'll let you watch that real quick.
I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just wanna be the one you love. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just wanna be the one you love. Lost all ambition, worldly acclaim. I just wanna be the one you love. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just wanna be the one you love. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just wanna be the one you love. Lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just wanna just be the one you love. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just wanna see the one you love.
Okay, now that we're back after that intro, pretty cool, right? They are currently releasing mods, the classic jumpsuit from Fallout 3, the New Vegas goals, well, the Fallout 3 and New Vegas goals. And they're even sharing textures with the Fallout 4 New Vegas team, so the Capital Wasteland team and the Fallout 4 New Vegas team. They both have a mutual friend called The Friend Turkey. That's his YouTube channel name. He's linked in the description below. Just like I said, everything else is. But basically, they're sharing textures and stuff, so it's kind of cool for both of them to be able to do that. You know, they don't have to do that for each other, but they are, so it's really nice. Which might mean you can have both of these mods installed at the same time. It'd be really cool if they added a feature. You go to the Boston airport and pay the Brotherhood to go take you Capital Wasteland or New Vegas. That would be very, very cool. But I am not sure if it's like adding DLC on, like how how Nuka World is, how it's your same character, or are you playing a different character. I don't know that yet, but if it's in-game, like you're still Nate or Nora, then it would be very cool to, you know, be able to pay, like, 1,000 caps to go to the Capital Wasteland, New Vegas. Be very cool. But yeah, like I said, they released a few mods for it, and, oh yeah, they also released the metal armor from Fallout 3. But I cannot wait to play this one in full HD as well. It looks very fun. I'll throw up a few, and I have some videos up already going through. Yeah. This one will also be coming out in a few years, but they're a decent way through with the, Point Lookout DLC, so you should be able to play that one maybe even in a few months. Probably the beginning of 2021 is when we're gonna start being able to play it. I'm assuming it's gonna cost money, because these are full-on, like, they had to recreate maps, you know. And it takes a lot of time, so I understand if it's gonna cost money. In fact, I might even buy New Vegas or our next one. But first off, have you considered subscribing? You know, I love Fallout content. I do other things besides that, but I'm trying to make a lot of Fallout content currently. And yeah. Follow me on Twitter at CrackenKing11. I also have an Instagram that should be linked below. But without further ado, we should probably hop into our third one. Fallout Miami. Okay, so this one looks great. It got multiple factions already. The map looks great here. I'll throw it up on screen. And honestly, it just has a very cool retro vibe. Even though it's like the apocalypse, it has such a cool vibe to it. And it has the same amount of energy as like Fallout New Vegas did, in my opinion. It looks really fun. And here's some amazing concept art they made, and they're even now making the concept art a reality in-game. So here's like this mutated golf cart course looking thing, and here's it in-game now. They completely recreated it, and it looks great. I'm loving it. I gotta say, this is probably one of my favorites besides the Fallout 4 New Vegas. Both number 1 and number 3 are definitely ones I'm going to have to get. Yeah. And there's, like, I love it. This power armor, I love this. The arcade power armor, I think that's dope. They made one standalone mod so far that you can download. And it's called the Quad Shotgun. So, you know, it shoots 4 shells at once. Pretty cool. Definitely a dope gun. And they also have gator claws in this mod, which, I mean, I don't know how they got there since, you know, they were kind of made in Nuka World, but sure. Ah, what the heck. I love this mod too much to be mad at it. It's just, it's so cool. They recently released a look at the map. So, yeah. And they're calling it basically equivalent to, like, a Nuka World DLC in size. Which, honestly, that's pretty good. From what I hear, there's going to be some good missions. But yeah, it's just, it looks so cool. This one is definitely the one I'm going to definitely get. I love it. And I haven't even played it yet. But it should be out in a year or so, year or two, looking at the development, how it's come so far. What did I just say? Yeah, but it's looking great. I'm loving it. And last on our list, Fallout 76 Appalachia. So this guy, his name is Desire. It's his YouTube channel name. It's linked in the description below. And he made, it's called Fallout 4 Appalachia. And, well, as the name states, it kind of remade Fallout 76 and Fallout 4. But with a twist, okay? Number one, you hop in this memory den right here. And that is how you get to Appalachia, but it's like 185 years later. 185 years after Fallout 76 takes place, I mean. I gotta say, this one's a pretty cool mod as well. Fallout 76 was never my game. I just never got into it. Maybe this mod will get me into it. Yeah, like I said, the author goes by the name Desire. But this mod isn't out yet, and it looks cool. There isn't much info, though. But yeah, I guess that's the last mod on our list. But definitely my top two picks are number one, Fallout 4 New Vegas, and the number three, Fallout Miami. And I'm going to leave you off with some of the trailers and stuff here. So thanks for watching. I'm Kraken King. And I'll see you soon. I'll see you next time. Yeah, I'm okay. Bye.
You're my earth. You're the planet. You're the grass, the wind and tide. And now that you're gone, I feel so out of place. And now that you're gone, I'm just drifting through space.
I was hoping that we could reform a land bridge between our separate pieces of the earth before our disconnect began to breed a species that would hurt much more than carnivores, herbivores.